Constitutional perfection? Question mark. An argument has erupted over whether or not the United States Constitution is the best legal document ever written. There are many in this country who believe our Constitution in its original form was a perfect document without flaws. This is an inane argument. It must be understood, not even the Founding Fathers believed that they had created a perfect document. Keep in mind, the Bill of Rights was added in 1791. Not only did they add the Bill of Rights, the 11th and 12th Amendments were added to the Constitution during the age of the Founding Fathers. Even they saw a need to correct perceived shortcomings in the very document they created. I would like to say the United States Constitution has many admirable features. Under our Constitution, ex post facto laws and bills of attainder are prohibited. Writs of habeas corpus cannot be suspended in peacetime. It is not a religious text and does not oblige its citizenry to take religious oaths and does not promote religious factions. Supremacy is not vested with a monarch or a dictator, and titles of nobility cannot be granted. Power is distributed among three branches in a manner which allows each to check the other. But the high-minded features of the Constitution cannot overshadow its deficiencies. The original Constitution is a pro-slavery document. It permitted black human beings to be declared property. The Constitution allowed for individual blacks to be considered three-fifths of a human being. It safeguarded the slave trade without congressional interference for 20 years. More importantly, the Constitution did not have a phase-out process for slavery. As a result of the Constitution's inadequacies in regards to Africans, Americans would fight a bloody civil war. The original Constitution would also do little in preserving the rights of its female citizenry. Women were not allowed to vote and were relegated socially. In fact, the Constitution only grants universal suffrage to property white males, which meant common white men could be denied the right to vote if they did not meet various qualifications. The Constitution does not allow for the populace to be the determining factor in selecting the president. The seminal factor is an electoral college. In conclusion, the Constitution has excellent features, but it also has major shortcomings. As for the United States Constitution of 1787 being the best ever written, it's ludicrous. I would like to think authors of any modern constitution would create a document respecting the dignity of every individual, no matter their racial, ethnic, or gender makeup. I would like to think no one would be considered less of a full human being. Everybody would be given the right to vote, and everybody's full human and civil rights would be protected from the encroachment of others. And if a constitution has, have these features, then that constitution is better than our 1787 constitution. And if anybody disagrees with this logic, then that person is longing for a time when one group was allowed to dominate others.